ओके स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम पढ़ेंगे जूल्स लॉ ऑफ हीटिंग इफेक्ट। अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस इफेक्ट द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट प्रोड्यूस्ड इन अ कंडक्टर ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस कैरिंग करंट आई फॉर द टाइम टी इज गिवन बाई एच इज इक्वल टू आई स्क्वायर आर टी। दैट मीन्स the heat will be proportional to the square of the current flowing through the conductor, right, at particular time. So in joule there will be h means heat is equal to I square RT, and if we can calculate in calorie, so we just divide this formula h is equal to I square RT by 4.2. Here is given h is equal to I square RT by J in calorie, right? So we have to also derive this power and energy. This is also known as heat energy, right? Electric power. So electric power is defined as the work done by the source of EMF in maintaining the current in the electric circuit. Okay. So power is equal to electric work done over time taken. So work done means energy. So energy P is equal to VI is equal to IR is equal to V square by R. Unit of power is watt. So see the derivation. How we derive is electrical energy. So electrical energy means work done to move charge from one point to another point is known as electrical energy, right? So if we talking about mechanical energy, so the mechanical work done to move the particular object from one point to another point, right? Here is talking about electrical work done. So electrical work done is to move charge from one point to another point. Means if we do the electrical work done, the electrical force is required, that is EMF, right? So dW is equal to F dot dx. After integrating we have Q square Q dot 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 over xb minus xa. So Q, one Q is separated and other one is the formula of potential V, that is force. So Q into V, right? And work done is the negative of potential energy and change in kinetic energy. Work energy theorem is change in kinetic energy is equal to the work done, right? So W is equal to, we can write Q as a I into T. So W is equal to I V T, yani energy will be V I T, right? As we see here, H is equal to I square RT over J. So I, if we introduce the resistance here, so I square R into T in joule, right? In calorie, we have to divide 4.2, right? So power, rate of change of electrical energy with respect to time, as we discuss here, time taken. So P is equal to VIT over T. So P is equal to VI, that is active power. Right, there are three types of power. Active power, P is equal to I square R, power loss or ohmic loss. We can see ohmic loss, right? This is power loss. If we talk about power loss, we apply this formula I square R. If we talk about power consumed, then we talk about have this formula P is equal to V square by R, right? Clear? अब अगर मैं बात करूं कि देयर विल बी many appliances connected in series or parallel. So what will be the power, effective power? So if we connect the electrical appliances in series, the effective power will be 1 by P is equal to 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3. If the electric appliances connected with series, the power will be reduced. And if the electrical appliances connected with the parallel, power will be increased, like P is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3 and so on, right? So you have to write this one, and we will talk about power and energy and further numerical portions also, right? So you can note down in your fair copy, and if you have any doubt, please ask me, right? Thank you.